So I thank you, Lord God, that this day was ordained for such a time as this. Lord, I thank you, Lord God, for allowing me to be a vessel to speak your word, Father. Father, I pray, Lord God, that this word will go forth unchecked, unhindered by any outside demonic force. In Jesus' mighty name, Lord, let the hearts of your people be cultivated, ready, Lord God, to receive your word. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you guys for coming out, and thank you for having me, because let me tell you, if you're in this place today, there is a reason today, and I thank God for it. Okay, I'm coming from, of course, Revelation chapter 8, the sound of the third trumpet, verses 10 through 11. I need to make sure you have your sword. There is a sword. I'm going to prove it to you later in the message. Now, there's going to be some preaching, some teaching, some revelations, some warnings, and some woes. Okay, I'm just going to tell you, but I got to let it flow. Okay, the Bible says, and I'm going to read the text. All right. Verse 8 says, and the second angel sounded, and as it were, a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ships were destroyed. And the, I'm sorry, did I read the wrong scripture? And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp, and it fell upon the third part of the river, and upon the fountains of the river. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became Wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter. Okay, a trumpet is used to make aware, to alarm, to alert, a warning of something to follow that means that there is a preparation that is going on and one that needs to take place. Hear me now, I said a preparation. Watch this. Warning is a form of mercy. And I thank God for it. Warning is a form of mercy. But we all know that he is long-suffering. But we also know that he says he will not always strive with man. Amen? Verse 11 says, and the name of the star is called Wormwood. Wormwood is a plant that has a very bitter taste, and it stands for the bitterness of God's judgment. This star that was called Wormwood fell upon the waters. The waters became bitter, and many men died because the waters were made bitter. Remember, I said that the sound of a trumpet also means preparation. If the waters were made bitter, you got to know that that water is going to be unfit to drink. There's a lot of people right now, they're stocking away food, they're stocking away water, and what do they call these people? Preppers. I'm just saying. A preparation that needs to take place. There is so much talk about asteroids near misses, how close asteroids is coming close to hitting the earth. Videos on YouTube about meteors and meteor showers. Many believe that this star that is called Wormwood to be that of a great asteroid. This message is out of the 8th chapter of Revelation. There is no coincidences with God. And I like to do this because I like to give God glory, because there's too many people that that you can say that this Bible is not real. There is no coincidences with God. I have you to know that Wormwood is mentioned in the Bible 8 times. We are in Revelation chapter 8. 8 signifies a resurrection, a regeneration, a new beginning. You know what I said? The trumpet blast has three purposes. To warn that judgment is certain. To call the forces of good and evil to battle. To announce the return of the king. These warnings is for us to make sure of our faith that we are a family fixed on Christ. Oh, boy. But can I just say, we can't be foot in the world, and one foot with God. And put your Bible in the back seat of the car until Sunday and say, hallelujah, I'm in church again. Trumpets are being sounded right now, everywhere. You have to have an ear to hear. So hear this. And for all those who are still in front of your TV, in front of TV, watching CNN, looking at Trump, what he doing, what he ain't doing, what the Lord say. The Lord say, don't look to the right or to the left. Keep your eyes on him. If you are greater and stayed up in Jesus Christ, you ain't got to worry about what Trump is doing. The Lord has given us clues in the Bible for those who have a problem with Trump. I'm not saying, no, I wasn't one that voted for him. I didn't vote for the other one. I voted for the Lord Jesus Christ, the one who was not on the ballot. But that is not what it's all about. It's about the Lord Jesus Christ. Mystery is made known. He plays on words. You have to have eyes to see and ears to hear. Watch this. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. Wait a minute, I don't think y'all heard.
Come on, man.
He said, at the sound of the last trumpet, what is the name of your president?
Come on.
What is the name of your president? Oh, God. God for you to hear this message. Everyone believer. Right. I don't say Christians anymore because
that's
they
right.
Come
me neither. Come on, a believer. I'm a believer. That's it.
One vision,
on one accord, let me tell you, all over the entire globe participates in this. Because when the Christians are out there at one time, when they're out there at one time, thunder, on one accord for Christ.
Lord,
on one accord for Christ.
Pentecost. Yes.
Let me tell you, the Spirit, woo, if you think you feel right now, the Spirit is getting ready to be poured out like you wouldn't believe. Amen. And we're going to be filled. You're going to be laying hands on the sick, and they shall recover. The Bible says, you think you got tongues now, you will have tongues of fire. You will not only be speaking in tongues, you're going to have languages that you ain't never heard before. I'm telling you, he's getting ready to pour out his Spirit, and it's going to be something like we ain't never seen. And I am grateful to God and glad to be a part of it and glad to be used by him, because I'm telling you, the world needs healing, and the world needs his love, and the only way to show it is to be out there and do what God has called us to do. Amen. That's my word for tonight.